here is the example of ammonia and boron trifluoride. Classify Lewis acid and Lewis base in the following examples. Ammonia and boron trifluoride. According to electronic configuration of ammonia, in the outermost shell of nitrogen, the nitrogen having a separate electron pair, and boron trifluoride is not having any electron pair. So ammonia, Lewis base, in ammonia nitrogen can donate an electron pair to boron trifluoride, and boron trifluoride, which is accepting the electron pair, it is called Lewis acid, and ammonia is called Lewis base. When nitrogen in ammonia transfer the electron pair to boron trifluoride, there is a bond between nitrogen and ammonia, nitrogen and boron. This bond is called coordinate covalent bond, this one, which is present between nitrogen and boron. This is due to the transfer of this electron pair, which nitrogen has transferred from ammonia to boron trifluoride. How you can identify that ammonia is a Lewis base and boron trifluoride is Lewis acid? For solving the problem, you have to understand the following points. Draw electronic structures of both species. Electronic structures of both species. These are the electronic structures in which electrons are present. Electrons are shown. The electronic structures are also in the form of dot and cross structures. The second point is look for the species that has a lone pair of electrons or negative charge. Look for that species which has a lone pair of electron. To identify the species which has the lone pair of electron, write down the electronic configuration of the central atom in ammonia and central atom in boron trifluoride. So you have to write the electronic configuration of nitrogen and electronic configuration of boron. Such a species has a complete octet, so it does not need any electron. The species which has a complete octet. Complete octets mean, if we are talking about first shell, the duplet rule is completed. If we are talking about the second shell, the octet rule, it means 8 electrons are present in the second orbital. When 8 electrons, the octet rule is not complete, then the electron is not the atom is not stable. It can, however, donate an electron pair. In this way, that atom can donate an electron pair because that atom is having the separate electron pair. This species is always a Lewis base. That species which is going to donate, which is going to transfer the electron pair to the other species, that species is called Lewis base, electron rich species, electron donating species. Look for the species that can accommodate an electron pair. The species which can accommodate, which can accept an electron pair is called Lewis acid. Such a species has incomplete octet. Those species which are electron deficient, having incomplete octet, they require electron from outside, so they accept electron from other species. So they are electron accepting species and called Lewis acid. So this species can accept an electron pair. This species is a Lewis acid. So that substance, that species which can accept an electron pair, according to Lewis concept, this species is a Lewis acid. First, you have to write electronic structures of both species in which the acid base reaction is going to happen. Look for the species that has a lone pair. For the identification of the presence of lone pair, you have to write the electronic configuration of the central atom. When you write the electronic configuration of central atom, then look at the first and the second shell. If the atom has a complete octet, so that atom does not need any electron. It means that electron is electron deficient and electron efficient because of the complete octet and can transfer an electron pair to other atom, to other species. It can, however, donate an electron pair and is called Lewis base. Then look at the second species, electronic configuration. Write the electronic configuration of the central atom of the second species. The species which have not, which has incomplete octet, has not 8 electron in their outermost shell. Those species are unstable species and electron deficient species and can accept electron pair from other substances. So those species are called Lewis acid. So in this way you can identify which substance is Lewis base and which is the Lewis acid. The substance which have electron in excess can transfer electrons and called Lewis base, and the substance which is electron deficient and cannot transfer and can accept an electron pair, it will be a Lewis acid. Then the next topic is self-ionization of water. To understand self-ionization of water, you have to understand the term ionization. What is ionization? Ionization means the formation of ions. Ions are positive ion or are negative ion. Positive ion is cation and the negative ion is anion. Positive ion is formed by the loss of electrons and negative ions are formed by the gain of electrons. When a neutral atom loses electron, it will form a cation. And when a neutral atom gains electron, it will form a anion. So in this way, atoms get ionized when they lose or gain electron. Loss of electron causes positive ions and gain of electron causes negative ions. Now self-ionization of water. Two water molecules produce a hydronium ion and a hydroxide ion by the transfer of proton. There are two water molecules. These two water molecules produces a hydronium ion and a hydroxyl ion. For example, from this water molecule, one hydrogen atom, a proton is transferred to the second water molecule. When this water molecule accepts a proton from this water molecule, it will form an hydronium ion, and the rest of the molecule hydroxyl ion form a anion which is negatively charged. So in this way, water is self-ionized. Self-ionized ka matlab hota hai khud ba khud ionize ho jana. Water ke molecule khud ba khud aapas mein milke ionize ho jate hain. Ek hydronium ion bana dete hain aur dusra hydroxyl ion. The formation of hydronium ion and the formation of hydroxyl ion, this is called self-ionization of water. In pure water is, in pure water, every time you make one hydronium, you get one hydroxyl ion. The water which is pure, it means there is no impurity present in the water. The water which is pure, you will always find a hydronium ion and a hydroxyl ion in that water. That is hydronium ion concentration. Concentration means the amount of ions present in molecule. Concentration of hydronium ion always equal to the concentration of hydroxyl ion. Jitne hydronium ion present honge water mein, utne hi hydroxyl ion present honge. So in pure water, every time when water molecule combines with the other water molecule, it will form a hydronium ion and a hydroxyl ion. The concentration of hydronium ion always equal to the concentration of hydroxyl ion. Ionization of water. Water molecule have a tendency to fall apart or dissociate. Dissociate means toot jana, kisi cheez ka decompose ho jana. Dissociation means to separate or disconnect from. When two water molecules separate from each other, in this way, there are hydrogen bonding present in water molecules. When this hydrogen bonding breaks down and a water molecule transfer a proton to the other water molecule, a hydronium ion is produced and the rest of the water molecule produce a hydroxyl ion. Hydronium ion is H3O positive ion, cation, and hydroxyl ion is OH negative, that is anion. So ionization of water caused because water molecules having tendency to fall apart, to dissociate. Water molecules have tendency to dissociate themselves, to dissociate the hydrogen bonding present between the water molecules. Due to the dissociation of hydrogen bonding which is present, which you can see in the form of this dotted line, this hydrogen bonding breaks and the water molecule reacts with each other, transfer protons from one water molecule to another water molecule, forming an hydronium ion and a hydroxyl ion. Self-ionization of water. Water undergoes self-ionization. Water can convert it into a proton and a hydroxyl ion. Due to this ionization, one water molecule accept that hydrogen ion and form hydroxyl ion. Hydronium ion, and the other one is hydroxyl ion. The concentration of hydrogen ions and hydroxide ions is extremely small. The concentrations are extremely small, but the concentration of hydrogen ion and hydroxyl ion are equal. The hydronium ion concentration is equal to the hydroxyl ion concentration. Actually, the hydronium ion is itself a proton. We can call it a proton. We can call it a hydrogen ion. So the concentration of hydrogen ion and hydronium ion is very small, but are equal. Both concentrations are equal, hydronium ion concentration and hydroxyl ion concentration, because the equilibrium lies very much on the left hand side. You can see here a double headed arrow, or also a double headed arrow in the second reaction, in which two water molecules react to each other. This double headed arrow indicates an equilibrium between reactants and products. Due to this equilibrium, the reaction is on left hand side, because the reaction is in backward direction. When the reaction is in backward direction at equilibrium, then the concentration of hydrogen and hydroxyl ion are small and the concentration of water is high. Any question from the self-ionization of water? Introduction. There is a brief introduction about self-ionization of water.